Today, I'd like to show you two examples for the mass boundary method. And my name is Hiroshi Suito from Tohoku University. Today, I'd like to show you two examples. The first one is a motion of aquatic plants called eelgrasses interacting with the water flows. This is a not so new result, very old one, and done by my former students, Mr. Tanino and Ms. Sato. But I think this is a very good example for the fluid structure interaction with immersed boundary method. And the second example is a blood flow simulation in the thoracic aorta by myself and Dr. Ueda. This is also another example for the immersed boundary method. So today you saw the immersed boundary method for the insects and cars. Then now you see the plants and blood vessels. Okay. So first one is eelgrass, so aquatic plants called eelgrass, which grows in the ocean from the sandy shallow bottom, and an area in which many eelgrass plants are found together is called an eelgrass bed. And two important sites on the eelgrass beds is existing in Japan. And the first one is the Seto Inland Sea in the west part of Japan. And another one is a Sanriku shore. And it was damaged hardly 6 years ago. But now it's recovering, they say. So this eelgrass beds plays a very important role in the coastal ecosystems, which supply the oxygen to the water by virtue of the photosynthesis, and providing an egg-laying site for the fish or many types. But in recent years, by the reclamation or shore protection works, the eelgrass bed is constantly decreasing. For example, this 30 years, it decreased 70% in the area. So it's a very severe situation. So recently, there are several trials for recovery by artificial transplantation like this. But the rates of the eelgrass germination or fixation rate is not so high, not very low, because only the 10 or 20% of the transplantation goes well, and another 80% is swept out. So we found that there is a trade-off relation in the water current speed. If the water current is too fast, the roots of eelgrass cannot stand against the high tension, and the eelgrass is swept away by the current. On the other hand, if the current is too slow, the eelgrass leaves become covered with mud, so the eelgrass cannot photosynthesize enough, and the eelgrass dies. So the flow situation of seawater strongly affects to the germination and the fixation rates in artificial transplantations. So, but the actual experiment is very high cost. It needs high cost because we need to put the plants in the transplantation in the sea. So the numerical simulation is a good tool for finding the optimal control of the water flow. So this is the water flow computation by immersed boundary method, and you see here the volume penalization terms, exactly same with Dr. Kolmensky. And U is the fluid flow speed, and UA is the speed of the plants. And A is a characteristic function, which takes the value 1 in eelgrass and 0 out of eelgrass. Okay? So the eelgrass is included as a volume penalization term that is proportional to the difference between the fluid and the eelgrass velocities. Okay? The flow equation, this equation is solved on the fixed Cartesian grid by using finite difference approximation with staggered grid arrangement. And for the motion of the plants, which is the structural mechanics, is represented as a balance of the acceleration, bending stiffness, tension, and external forces. And this equation means the length of each segment should be constant, similar to the incompressible conditions of the fluid flow. So by discretizing the governing equations for the structure, we obtain this kind of Poisson equation. T is a tension, and this part becomes zero if the incompressible, inextensible condition is satisfied. So this is the balance between the tension and the external force. And in this computation, the tension plays a very similar role of the pressure in the incompressible flow computation. Then the iterative coupling is adopted. First, we compute the structure for the plant. Then the velocity of each segment, UA, and the existence of a plant, represented by A, is given to the fluid equation. And after computing this equation, then the force integration of the pressure around the eel grass is given from fluid part to the structural part. And this is a fluid structure interaction, the iterative method. So these are the test calculations. And this is the bent eel grass becomes straight because of the effect of the bending stiffness force. And bending stiffness and the buoyancy, the entire eel grass plants rise become because of the buoyancy effect. And in this study, we use a repulsive force is used to prevent the eel grass from passing through the each other or through the bottom surface. We used Leonard Jones type potentials. And this is a test calculation for using unrealistically strong repulsive force, but it goes very well. So, and also we need some high accuracy around the structure. So we used the overset grids. So we use finer mesh around the structure. Structure means eel grass, like this. Okay. So this is some coupled simulation for first one, only one eel grass. The eel grass is almost at rest in this case, when the vertical component of the force that the eel grass receives from the flow and the buoyancy are balanced. And if we use the 9 eel grasses, it starts to oscillate because of the flow field complexity increases as a result of the increasing of number of eel grass plants. And if we set 100 eel grasses, it's possible to compute. But for this case, if we use the boundary fitted strategy, not using immersed boundary method, we can compute also. But for this case, it's impossible, very complex, but not so complex for the CAD data, but still very complex. So it only can be computed by using immersed boundary method. So this is the side view and the back view. I don't draw the velocity vectors, but there is a flow around this. And you can see that eel grasses starts to oscillate, fluttering motion. So this kind of fluttering motion is important from biological points of view, which enables eel grasses to shake the mud off its leaves. Okay. So this is a horizontal cross section near the bottom. This is these 9 eel grasses. This is the isolines of the characteristic function, and you see the Kalman vortex-like structure downstream of the eel grasses. And this is a cross section near the water surface. So near the water surface, the eel grass can move freely. The more complex structure can be seen in the downstream. So in this case, we set many eel grasses, and it moves. And this is the conclusion of the first part. The fluttering motion of eel grass is simulated by fluid structure interaction with the immersed boundary method. This fluttering motion is important from biological points of view, which enables eel grass to shake the mud off its leaves. And by using the immersed boundary method, we can various flow situations can be simulated and compared to find an optimal flow control. For example, putting some obstacle in the flow or something. So this is difficult, but if we don't use the immersive boundary method. Of course, the more precise evaluation for force from fluid to solid is necessary. So this is our next step. And next part, I'd like to show you some blood flow simulation. For as you know, our largest artery is aorta, called aorta, in Japanese, daidomyaku. And here is the heart here, and it go upward and then turned downward. And there are several life-threatening diseases, such as aortic aneurysm or aortic dissections. It presents a risk of rupture, and many reports have described the risk factors, but the natural history of aneurysm development remains unclear. So there are several factors influencing the cardiovascular diseases. And for example, lifestyles. I don't know how much you drank last night and how much you drink today. But it affects your life, your health, of course, sometimes positive and sometimes negative. And another factor is inheritable characters, different from person to person. And for inheritable characters of our organs, vessels, or some other parts. Another factor is morphology of our organs. This is an example for the 32 thoracic aorta in the here shapes. And so you can see that there are a wide variety for the shapes of the aorta among the individuals. So these characters, these influencing factors brings about the disease as a result, but we concentrate to the morphology because it is very easy to understand and we can obtain this morphology data from the CT scans or something. So if the morphology is different, the flow characteristic should be different. And also it brings about the different vessel wall stresses. And vessel wall stresses is strongly related to the several cardiovascular diseases. So simulation using the medical imaging data procedure is like this. So by using the CT or MRI, we obtain some CT data. This is myself. And by using these data, we can obtain the geometry of our organ, targeted organs. But this data is very, very dirty. Different meaning from the presentation by Dr. Onishi, but this data includes many small bumps and something. And sometimes it comes from the noise of the CT measurement, or sometimes movement of the patient. But sometimes it is not noise, but some calcification of the vessels. Calcification means some calcium or something is attached to the inner wall. I cannot distinguish the noise and the calcification. So we should see this data with the surgeons, cardiovascular surgeons, and oh, this is a noise, ah, this is a calcification, and taking very long time also. For when I made this data, this is a coarctation. This is a very narrow part here. We need 8 hours together. Anyway, if we use different techniques, such as phase contrast MRI, we can obtain the luminance proportional to the velocity, and we can obtain the flow profile on the several cross sections here, and some branches. And these data can be used as the boundary conditions. And then we obtain the flow simulations. So the problem is very similar. So this part is much most time consuming for the preparation of the data. And you already know the strategies for the immersive boundary method, but I prepared this slide. This is a very simple immersive boundary method, and this is easy, not easy, I now understand, but I think that it is easier than the boundary fitted approach. In our case, blood vessels are represented by using immersive boundary method, but you can see that there are a lot of wasted meshes here and here. And another problem is insufficient resolution for boundary layers, like here and here. So another strategy is to use the boundary fitted mesh, but this it's very time consuming and difficult to generate such a boundary fitted mesh. But strong point is that the sufficient resolution can be achieved for the boundary layers. So I think there is a hybrid approach like this. This is in this mesh system, one of the mesh lines is along the main flow direction. So this type is called boundary fitted mesh, but I call this center line fitted mesh. Center line, it means the center line of the blood vessels. So this approach is relatively easy for mesh generation than this strategy, and relatively high accurate than this one. So I'm going to present this approach. This is sometimes called interface capturing and interface tracking, and this is a hybrid one. So we have the morphology data from CT images for different patients. Then we extract the center line and the radius data for each point of the center lines, and we can make the center line fitted finite difference mesh. Not exactly same, but the smoothly fitted to the center line. And we can construct a characteristic function. Here I write lambda, but same as A in the previous case. And it takes a value 1 in the outside of aorta and takes a value 0 inside of aorta. And then the aorta shape is reconstructed like this. Then using this mesh system, we can compute the flow field by using Navier-Stokes equations with the volume penalization term. And this is a sum result. We draw the streamlines like this. And I'd like to explain about the Dean's vortices, something about the physics. We sometimes see the characteristic secondary flows in the curved tubes. If this is a cross section of the vessel, and if the straight in the circular straight tubes, Hagen-Poiseuille-like flow profile is achieved, and the flow is perpendicular to the screen. And if there is a curvature, there is a centrifugal force is acts on in the opposite direction of the curvature, but the centrifugal force is proportional to the velocity in the axis direction. Consequently, that the opposite sign set of opposite sign vortices is generated as a secondary flow. This phenomenon is governed by the Dean's number. It is defined by the ratio between diameter of the vessel and radius of curvature. And in the human aorta case, it's very large because our aorta is about 2 or 3 centimeters diameter, and the radius of curvature is like this, several centimeters. So the Dean's number is very high. And this is a flow simulation result. And I'd like to show you. This is a streamline, instantaneous streamlines. And the color means a velocity magnitude. So the red part means velocity is very high. And here you can see the circulation. And this is caused by the aneurysm. It's very simple. But here, you see the Dean's vortices superimposed to the main flow, because you see here this one and this one. And this is the high speed area come come to the near wall area, and this brings about the high wall shusters here. So this is some cause of the cardiovascular disease. And by computing another patient cases, we can see sometimes similar and but sometimes different circulation patterns. And for this case, the similar circulation we can see. And for this case, the different shapes brings about a different circulation. You see the and this is cross-sectional, but in this case, longitudinal circulation can be seen. And in the different case, we see some stagnation point here. This is caused by the combination of the between the radius difference and the torsion of the vessel itself. So if the vessel is straight, the pause-like flow profile is achieved. So the strong velocity is confined to the center region of the vessel. But in the case with curvature or torsion of the vessel, this strong velocity is conducted to the near wall region, which causes strong wall shear stresses. And immersed boundary method allows us to, boundary method is capable of simulating many cases and is useful to understand the essential difference between morphologies. If we need to, actually, I'm now computing this kind of vessel by using the finite element method with the unstructured boundary fitted mesh, but it's very time consuming and still the immersed boundary method is very efficient to understand the essential difference between the different morphologies. And in today, MHD simulations presentations, we saw the helicity. So I put this slide here. Also, we see the helicity in the curved vessels. The red one is clockwise, and blue one is counterclockwise. And this is a heartbeat. And in the peak systole phase, peak systole means this area, we see the positive and the negative helicity, and this like this. But it only one helicity, high helicity area remains for the late diastole phase. Diastole means in Japanese, kakuchoki. So this is very slightly strange. So we obtain, we draw the secondary flows for the non-torsion case and the with torsion case, but you can see the secondary flows is symmetric for the zero torsion case, but it's not symmetric. And this small vortex becomes large and merging the other vortexes, and then form one large vortex. This is the cause of this remaining helicity area. And this causes, this means that the wall, blood wall, vessel wall receiving the torques all during the heart period. So it's also dangerous for our health. Okay. So this is the final slide. That immersed boundary method can be easily applied to real world, can be applied to real world problems. And of course, to achieve an acceptable resolution for the realistic flow field with reasonable computational cost, we can consider several strategies. The first one is using the very fine mesh overset or multi-block method on Cartesian mesh. This is a very important one. And another, today, no presentation like this, but using the boundary fitted unstructured mesh called the interface tracking is also very important for some kind of problems. And as I showed here, a hybrid strategy between A and B are also possible, but this strategy is depending on the individual problems. And in this case, in our vessel blood flow case, centerline fitted mesh is appropriate. So this concludes my presentation. Thank you for your kind attention.